Hey guys, this is Brent with Western Equipment. It can be difficult at times picking which John Deere 5E series tractor best fits your operation, but today I'm going to give you some help. We're going to talk about three very important things to get you on the right track of choosing that tractor. So we're going to talk about engine horsepower, PTO horsepower, and loader lift capacity. So let's get started. First thing we're going to talk about is engine horsepower, but before we do that, let's break down the John Deere model numbers just a little bit. On these tractors, we've got first starting out with the 5 here. This is going to be the 5 series family. The next three are going to be your horsepower range. So on this tractor, it is a 45 horsepower, and the letter at the end is going to be your trim level, which is the E here. E trim level is going to be that economy trim level. It's kind of your base level, but also your workhorse tractor. So in all these tractors, we'll be looking at E's. So on this tractor here, we've got a 45 horse open station. Next, we have a 55 horse cab tractor. In between it that we don't have here would be a 65 horse, 75 horse, and 90 horse. And we also have the 100 horse all the way at the end there. So within this family, we've got six tractors within this 5E series. So various horsepower ranges there. And why is that important? That's important, guys, because horsepower is what we're basing all of our decisions off of. With more horsepower comes more lifting capacity on the front, more lifting capacity at the rear, and more PTO horsepower. So the horsepower of the engine determines what all implements we can pull, what things we can lift. Everything deviates from this right here. So from there, guys, just remember, six horsepowers within this series, all the way from 45 to 100. So now let's talk a little bit about loader lifting capacities. Right here, we've got our 45 horse again. So on this tractor, you can put two different loaders. There are three loaders total that you can put on the E-Series. On this tractor here, you can do either the 512 or the 520M, giving you a range from 2200 to 3600. Now, why is it different? Because this horsepower is the same here. Guys, loader structure also changes what our lifting capacities would be. So the 512 would be a little lighter loader, the 520M, a little heavier loader, giving you that extra lifting capacity. As we go over to the 55 horsepower tractor, we can do those same two loaders, either the 512 or the 520. So giving you also those same capacities here, 2200 or 3600. As we bump up into that 65 and 75, you're now limited to that 520 loader, giving you the 3600 pound lifting capacity. And then once we get to the 90 and 100 horse, you have another option of the 540, giving you 3800 pounds of lifting capacity once you get to the 90 and 100. So there is a break there too, guys, that we're going to talk just a little bit about here. Once you get to the 90 and 100, you've gone also to a four-cylinder engine, as opposed to a three-cylinder engine in the 75, 65, 55, and 45. So all that means going from the three-cylinder to the four-cylinder is more power, and also means a little bit larger frame, a little bit larger tractor overall, giving you that extra ability for that larger loader with that more lifting capacity. So we've got a range here on the 45 to 75 between 2200 to 3600 pounds. And if we go up to the 90 and 100 series, we go all the way up to that 3800 pounds. So loader lifting capacity could be huge in making your decision, depending on if we're lifting round bales, whether we're moving dirt, maybe we're lifting loads of pipe, whatever those things may be, that amount of weight that you can lift in the front will be very, very crucial to helping you make your decision. So from here, guys, let's go to the rear, talk about the PTO horsepower and what type of implements we can pull. Here at the rear, let's talk about PTO horsepower and what that translates to as far as implements that you can pull with these tractors. So across all tractors, no matter what brand and what size of tractor, there's a difference between engine horsepower and PTO horsepower. On this tractor, for instance, we have 45 engine horsepower and 37 horsepower at the rear. Now the difference comes because you have to have horsepower at the engine to continue to run the engine while also translating that horsepower to the rear to run that rear implement. So 45 to 37. What that 37 translates to as far as how big of implements you can pull. On the end here, we're going to talk a lot about shredders, box blades, and eventually talk about hay equipment. So on this tractor in particular, 7-foot shredder, you have two options there also. You can either do 3-point mounted, which when you mount it to the 3-point here, you're going to be very limited to that 7-foot range, being as you're putting more stress on the rear, taking more horsepower to run the engine. So you're going to have to stay very specific to that 7-foot. Now you can also do draw bar. So pulled a pulled shredder here, which is, you know, you could increase, you might be able to hit that 8 foot range or get a little bit bigger than that 7, somewhere in between, being as you'll have a little bit of extra horsepower pulling with that drawbar rather than with your 3-point. So there is that difference there, so keep that in mind. As we move up, maybe we want to look at moving into that 8 foot or 10 foot shredder. If that's the case, we have to move up here to the 55 horsepower at the engine, because that translates to 41 here at the PTO. So once we get there, like I said, we're looking at that 8 foot shredder, 8 foot box blade, 10 foot shredder, 10 foot box blade. You have that variation of that change going from 4 horsepower bigger, from the 37 horsepower at the PTO here to 41 at the PTO here. Now, if we want to move up into those bigger shredders, maybe like a 15-foot bat wing, we need to look at the 65 engine horsepower tractor, which is not shown here. Because once we get into the 65 engine horsepower, we're looking at 53 at the PTO, which is large enough to run that 15-foot bat wing shredder. Now, we want to get a little bigger. We're looking at our 75 engine horsepower. We get into 60 PTO horsepower. Now we're getting up into that range. We're able to run those livestock implements, such as those feed grinders, those smaller hay implements like the rotary rakes, and still staying in that category, we can run that 15-foot shredder. Now, once we break from the 75 engine horsepower into the 90 and 100, now we're talking larger frame, larger engine, because remember, when we go up from the 45, 55, 65, and 75 horsepower tractors into the 90 to 100, you're moving from a 3-cylinder engine to a 4-cylinder engine. So like we said, along with that comes a larger frame, wider width, longer wheelbase, extra ride comfort, things like that. Now we're able to pull those larger implements. Once we get here, we're talking about things like an 18-foot, 20-foot batwing shredder. So we're covering more ground, we're being more productive, we have a broader range of implements we can pull. If we talk about the 100 horsepower tractor in particular, we're getting into that range where now we're talking a in-the-field hay tractor. Like we said at the front, we have that lifting capacity, 3,800 pounds, so we have plenty of lifting capacity for those hay bales, moving them through the field, you know, stacking them on the truck, making stacks. We also have enough PTO horsepower, being from 100 to 85, to run that 560M John Deere baler. You know, we're able to run those hay implements, those bigger rakes. We have that more pulling capacity here at the drawbar, 85 horsepower at the rear. On the 90, we go from 90 to 75. So you've still got a wide range, the 18-foot, 20-foot shredder, those bigger implements. Just as you move up, guys, you're going to increase that PTO horsepower corresponding with your engine horsepower, just opening up different levels of implements. So always, when you're out there shopping for those different implements and trying to make those decisions on which tractor you need, whether it be all the way down at the 45 to pull just your 7-foot shredder and box blade for around your home place, or you need to get up into, say, a 15-foot shredder for that extra pasture land. Now we're looking into the 65 horsepower tractor. Or say we're looking at a price conscious way to get into a hay tractor, maybe we need to look at our 5100, get into the 100 engine horsepower and 85 PTO to run those balers, those bigger rakes, things like that. Have the extra lifting capacity to move those hay bales. All of these factors we've talked about, engine horsepower, PTO horsepower, lifting capacities, all things that will help make your decision on which tractor you need. So like we've talked about before, do your homework. Make sure we're staying within the capacities on the loader that we need to be to lift what we're talking about lifting. Staying within the PTO horsepower we need to pull what implement we're looking at. So guys, I hope that you've liked what you've seen. You've seen the difference between these tractors. If you have any other questions, please comment below or get in contact with us. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Remember that time Brent and James tried to go shoot videos and it was already 2:40 and we haven't done squat?
What the heck?
Taller in stature. The same thing. Stature. Dang it, dude. Oh my gosh. All right, you ready? I'm sick of you messing up. Hey guys, this is Brent with Western Equipment. Being as it's a 5E series, ranges which tractor we need to fit our start over. So you'll be able to pull those bigger implements. Dude, I'm... And then you have to have that power translate to the rear. And let's start over because I'm stuttering. Okay, at the rear, let's talk about PT... Why do I keep saying that? We need to start with three steps. Engine horsepower. Dang it. I keep wanting to change it and make it better, and I just can't.